Hi guys, welcome to Code Bashers. In this video, I will be discussing the coding questions which are asked in Mindtree. This is part 1 of this series, more parts will be coming in the future. So guys, make sure that you subscribe to this YouTube channel. Guys, if you have not joined my Telegram group till now, please join it. I post regular updates on different companies which are hiring, as well as the different coding questions which are getting asked in them. The link of the Telegram group is given in the description box. So guys, now let's start this video, and before starting the video, please hit the like button as well as the subscribe button for this channel. Okay, so the question asked in Mindtree are very average level. So the question we will be discussing in this video is here. See, find out whether the number is lucky or not. A number is said to be lucky if the sum of the first half digits of the number is equivalent to the sum of the second half digits of the number. Okay, so see, in this question what we have to do, we are given an input number and we have to find out whether that number is lucky or not. And lucky number means that the sum of the digits of the first half of the number is equivalent to the sum of the second half digits of the number. If these two sums are equal, then the number is said to be lucky. So let's see an example. See, we are given an input number that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So first of all, what we'll do, we will calculate the sum of the first half of the digits. See, total digits here is 6. Total digits are 6. So first half will contain 3 digits and second half will again contain 3 digits. Okay, so now first we'll calculate the sum of the first half. So sum of the first half will be, see, this is 1, 2, 3. So 1 plus 2 plus 3, it is 6. So this is the sum of the first half. And now we'll be calculating the sum of the second half. Sum of the second half will be 4, 5, 6. So 4 plus 5 plus 6, it will give us 15. So see, sum of first half is 6 and sum of second half is 15. So these two sums are not equal. It means that this number is not lucky. So in the output, what we'll do, we'll simply print no. That is no, that is not lucky. Now, if these two sums were equal, then we would have printed yes. That is, this number is lucky. Now, there is one note given in this question. That is, number will always have even digits. See, here the number of digits is 6, which is even. Again, the input number can't have 7 digits. Now, you can see that here the digits are 7. So, it cannot have odd number of digits. So, it will only have the even number of digits. So, this is possible, like 8 and 6. Now, the digits have become even. So, this was the entire question. I hope this question is clear to you. Now, we'll be looking at the code for this question. Okay. So, I'll be writing the code in C++, but all the logic for all the languages are same. So, I hope you will be able to solve in different languages also. So, first of all, what we'll do, we will take number as input. Let's suppose int n, and we will take this number as input, that is C in n. Now, see, first of all, what we have to do, we have to calculate the length of the input number. So, we know that this is 6, but how we will be calculating it? So, first of all, what we'll do, we will simply calculate the length of the input number. So, for that, what we'll do, we will take int temp variable, and in that temp variable, we'll store n, that is the input number. Now, we have to calculate the length of the input number. So, let's suppose int len is equal to 0, this variable will store the length of the number. Okay. So, while our temp is greater than 0, so what it will do? It will do length plus plus. This loop will do length plus plus, and it will do temp is equal to temp divided by 10. Let's suppose this while loop will only calculate the length of the input number. So let's suppose our input number was 12. Okay, so our length was 0. So let's suppose length was 0. Now we will go inside this loop. While our temp is greater than 0, so our 12 is greater than 0, so our length will become plus plus. So length will now become 1. Now again, temp is equal to temp divided by 10. So this was our temp. So 12 divided by 10 is 1. So 12 divided by 10 is 1. Now again, this loop will run. That is, while our temp is greater than 0. So 1 is greater than 0. So yes, it is greater than 0. Now again, in this loop, we will do length plus plus. Now our length will become 2. And we'll do temp is equal to temp divided by 10. That is, 1 divided by 10, we know that it is 0. So again, when it will go upper, on the upside, this condition will be false, that temp is greater than 0. In reality, temp is 0. So this loop will get breaked and our length will be 2. So we have found that our length have become 2. Now what we'll do, we know that in the question it is given that our length will always be even. Either it will be 2, 4, 6, 8 or 10. It cannot be odd. So what we'll do, we will take another variable which will store the half length. So let's say int half length. Now this will contain length divided by 2. Length divided by 2. Now let's suppose our length was 2, and then our half length will become 1 only. That is, length divided by 2, that is 2 divided by 2, it will be 1 only. So here, this is the example that I have taken. That is, our input number was 12. Okay. So now our half length has become 2. So first we have to do, we have to find the first half and the second half. So again, let's take two variables. Let's say two variables, that is int first, it will be 0. It will store the sum of the first half of the numbers, and second one is int second is equivalent to 0. It will store the sum of the second half of the digits. Now what we'll do, we will do while our see, half length will be length divided by 2, that is 1. So two half lengths will give us one length. So wait a second. So our temp was initially, temp was equivalent to 12, as we know that input number is 12. So when our half length that is 1, when our half length is greater than 0, again when our half length is greater than 0. So here half length was 1, we know that. Now till this condition is true, then what will happen inside our while loop, it will be, wait a second. Okay, so yes, so till our half length is true, then what will happen? See, we know that we can take the digits from behind by simply doing mod of 10. So what we'll do, int r is equivalent to, what was our number, that is n mod 10. Okay, now see, so it was not temp, it was n. Why temp was not taken? See, while we were doing this operation, our temp value has reached to 0. So again, in this while loop we can't use the value of n, we can't use the value of temp because it is already 0. So this loop will never run. So see, our r is equivalent to n mod 10. So what will be n mod 10? N mod 10 will give us 12 mod 10 will give us 2. Now what we'll do, this is the digit we are taking from behind. This is the digit we are taking from behind. So it will contribute in this variable, in the sum of second half of the values. So what we'll do, we'll simply do second plus is equivalent to r. So this two digit, is second digit will be stored in the second half, this variable, that is second half of the number. Now what we'll do, we'll do half length minus minus. Okay, and in the end what we'll do, see, here it was 12. Now next time when we come, we have to take this one only. So for that, what we'll do, we'll simply do n is equivalent to n divided by 10. So this entire while loop will give us the sum of the second half of the digits. So see, for on this example, n is equivalent to 12. So first of all, we go inside this loop, our r becomes n mod 10, that is 2. So r is equivalent to 2 now. Now second was initially 0, now second plus is equivalent to r. So second plus r will give us, second has become 2. Now we have done half length minus minus. So our length was 2, half length will be 1 only. So after this, we have done half length minus minus. So now when we have done half length minus minus, so it has become 0 because half length was 1 earlier. Now we'll do n is equal to n divided by 10. So now 12 divided by 10 will be 1 only. So now new n has become 1. So after this loop is over, our second half of the sum of the second half of the digits is 2 only. As we know that in 12, 1 will be the sum of the first half digits and 2 will be the sum of the second half digits. So we have got the sum of the second half digits. So it is 2. Now again see, what was our half length? What we'll do, our half length is over. It means that when the length was 2, our one iteration is over. Now we have to do one more iteration, and in that half length, we have to take the sum of the first half digits. So now what we'll do, we'll again initialize with half length is equivalent to length divided by 2. I hope this thing is clear, because once we are over this while loop, our first half length is over. Now we have to calculate the second half length also. So half length is equal to length divided by 2. Now again what we'll do, we'll simply do while this. So let's just copy the entire while loop only. So upper while loop was to calculate the sum of the second half of digits. Now the below while loop will be to calculate the sum of the first half digits. So here will be only one change, that is we will not do second plus is equal to r, we will simply do first plus is equal to r. So I hope this while loop is clear, because it is similar to above while loop. After the first while loop, our original number has reduced by half, r is reduced to half digits, and that half digits will be used in this while loop, and in this while loop our sum will be incremented to this first variable. So now we have got our second half of the sum in second variable and first half sum in the first variable. Now if the number is lucky, it means that the value of first and second should be equal. So if our first is double equivalent to second, then it means that our number is lucky. So we will simply see out yes. And if this condition is not fulfilled, it means our loop is going into else. It means that first is not equivalent to second. So in this case, we will simply do cout no. So this was the entire code. I hope this code is clear to you. Now what we'll do, we will simply run it on certain test cases. So let's just say we will run it on first test case is 1, 2, and we know that 12 is not a lucky number because the sum of first half digit is 1 and the sum of second half digit is 2. So it should come out to be no. So here you can see that output is coming out to be no. And let's just now change it to, let's say 2, 2, 2, 2. So total there are 4 digits that are even and all the digits are 2. So in this case, we know that this is a lucky number because first half digit sum is 4 and second half digit sum is also 4. So you can see that yes is coming. So it means that this is a lucky number. So guys, this was all for the code and all the test cases will be passed on this code. So I hope you liked the video. If you want more such parts, please comment down. Thank you for watching it.